So here we are
at the last topic of this particular chapter, light refraction and reflection. So we are at the last point or the last topic of this one. We'll complete this. We'll solve one numerical and you'll have to complete the complete exercise, the full exercise of this chapter in your textbook. And in case those who don't have textbook, I will send you all the PDF copy of that. Please finish the exercise and then we will move on to the next chapter. Okay? So fine. So we'll begin with the last topic of this one, that is power of a lens. And power of a lens is a very applicative part of this chapter. Okay, so applicative part means where the application of lens, where will I apply the lens or use the lenses and how will I use it, and those are the things which we'll be dealing with this particular topic. Okay, so let's understand what is this power of a lens before going to the exact meaning or definition of power of a lens. I'll begin with the certain simple topics of this. That is, first one, I'll tell you all something about convex lens. That is, convex lens of short focal length bends the light through the large angles by focusing them closer to the optical center. So I'll give you all an example. Okay, this sentence, you will think about it, I'll tell you all. Let me take a lens and then pass a beam of light, a ray of a light, okay? Then it will bend, and it bends at much of an angle, okay? So let me say, a more bending takes place. That is, if the light rays are traveling parallel, it will bend more than the usual. If it bends more, that time I can tell that this particular thing has through a large angles by focusing them closer to the optical center. And this type of a focus point will be very much closer to that of the optical center. Okay, and these type of lens in which the thickness is more, when the thickness is more, what happens, light rays will pass through them, and when after traveling parallel, after happening of a refraction, the refracted rays will bend at a much higher angle and end up falling very closer to that of the optical center. Okay, so when it falls closer to the optical center, the focal length formed will be very less, very small. And that is closer to the optical center. That is what the first sentence tells. Convex lens of short focal length bends the ray at larger angles by focusing them closer to the optical center. Okay, this is what it tells. And if at all, the same sentence if I tell in the other way, that is, convex lens of larger focal length. Okay, if the focal length is more or the lens is thinner, if the lens is thinner, what happens is, the light ray will pass through this thin lens, okay, parallelly. Then after that, the refraction takes place. The refracted angle is lesser when compared to the previous case, okay. The lesser angle, what happens is the converging takes place and falls on the much farther point. That means the focus point is much farther than that of the optical center. So, a little more farther than that of the optical center. So, you can see in this case, the F1 distance, that is focal length in the first case, is much smaller than that of the focal length in the second case. Okay, so you can see here, there are two focal lengths in the two diagrams I have drawn, F1 and F2. F1 is a small short focal length lens and F2 is a larger focal length. Okay, so here these are the two cases what I can understand about larger focal length and the shorter focal length. The larger angle of refraction or bending takes place in the shorter focal length, and the larger, the smaller angles, deflection takes place when the focal length is larger or more. Okay, so understand this concept clearly. You should imagine this and understand it. Okay, though the explanation, how much ever I give, you will end up getting confused. Better than that is, you understand, imagine two lenses and imagine the rays, how will they bend and all that. So then you will understand it more clearly. We'll move on to the next one and the same similar concept but using the concave lens. Okay, so in case of concave lens of very short focal length causes higher divergence. Here what happened, it was bending closer, that is focusing, converging takes place. As you know, convex lens is a converging lens whereas concave lens is a diverging lens. So if the focal length was short in case of a concave lens, the divergence will be more, that is the deflection of this light is more, which means they will end up in the opposite direction, okay, like this, and they will form a focal point which is closer to that of the optic center. It was same as that of this case in case of a concave mirror. If the very short focal length very short focal length of a concave mirror causes higher divergence, which means focal length is shorter. So what same thing happens in the longer focal length? Divergence is less. Lesser divergence, which means the focal length is much more larger than that of the previous one. Okay, so clearly understand these two concepts. Why? Because therefore I will be explaining the term of power of a lens using these understanding examples. So here comes the term that expresses the degree of divergence or divergence of a light rays achieved by lens is called as power of a lens. How much a lens can diverge or converge, okay, that is called as power of a lens. So more applicative wise, if I tell how it is generally used in real life, this is what the lens I have told you all which will be used here. In this glass, I am telling you all this is a lens that is called as a concave lens. This lens will be used and this lens has certain power. I am very sure all have heard about lenses having power, that is glasses having different power. People using glasses, you might have heard them, I am like telling them my glasses of so and so much power and all that. So that is what they mean. Power means how much converging the light rays coming from the outside, how much it will converge or diverge, how much capacity this lens has to converge or diverge, that is called as power of a lens. Okay, so understand it more applicative wise rather than the simply definition wise. The degree of divergence is what they are telling, that is amount of divergence or convergence, whether it is going to diverge or whether it is going to converge, how much amount it is taking place, and that is the term that defines the power of a lens. Okay, so power of a lens is nothing but the term that expresses the degree of convergence or divergence of the light rays achieved by a lens. Yeah, so then it is also defined, not defined but more like it is expressed as a formula for power of a lens. A formula for power of a lens is 1 by focal length, that is reciprocal of a focal length. So reciprocal of a focal length means just 1 by focal length, and you already know SI unit of a focal length is meter, which means SI unit of power is 1 by meter or per meter or meter minus 1. Yes, so this one is a general understanding of SI unit, but there is a standard unit for power of a lens, that is diopter. Okay, this is called as diopter, don't call it as dioptrie. So it is diopter. So in that diopter, capital D is its indication. So fine. So capital D diopter means nothing but per meter or meter minus 1. Clear? So understand this SI unit power, and you need to remember the spelling as well as the word diopter, and the indication for that is capital D, the uppercase letter D. Fine. So what they'll ask is these two things, the short focal length and the larger focal length or whatever convergent divergent is, that they will ask it in the case of multiple choice questions or maybe fill in the blanks. Whereas the definition will be asked in terms of 2 marks or 3 marks questions, including the formula and including its SI unit. Clear? So they might ask this question in something like this: as a defined power of a lens, write a formula for the same, and what is the SI unit of power of a lens? So this is how they might ask directly. There are a lot of indirect ways of asking the questions. Think about it and frame a question for you. Fine. So then the power of a convex lens is positive. Convex lens power is always positive, whereas power of a concave lens is negative. Okay, so you all might have heard about people telling their power, the lens's power, that is glass power, is minus 2.5 or minus 1.5, something like that. So whereas mine is minus 2.25, so which means minus means my lens, whatever I'm using over here, is a concave lens. Okay, which means I'm not able to see the farther objects clearly, so I'm using a concave lens. Whereas I'll get back to this particular far-sightedness and near-sightedness in the next chapter. Okay, so whereas in that chapter you'll be knowing what is this glasses, eyeglasses, and what are the types of glasses we use in lenses we use in these type of glasses. Okay, when is convex lens used and when is concave lens used? So, but remember this one thing. This I will recall once again in the next chapter. This concept is of power of a lens is positive, that is power of a concave lens is negative and a convex lens is positive. Remember this, do not forget. Okay, next I'll move on to the numerical. One of the example I will solve, and the other example you will solve in the textbook, that is the textbook example you will solve, and the exercise problems you have lot of numericals present in that.
please solve it and let me know if you have any doubts in this. Fine. So I will do one sum for your reference and how to solve one particular sum. This sum is already there in your textbook, so I'll just explain roughly. So in case you don't get any sum in the exercise questions, please let me know. I will solve that sum in the next coming video. Fine. So listen to this question. It is example number 10.4 in the page number 182. Okay, 182 of your textbook. The example number 10.4. So in that question, they are telling a 2 centimeter tall object. A 2 centimeter tall object. Imagine a doll. A doll of 2 centimeter is kept here in front of a convex mirror. They are given perpendicular to the principal axis. Perpendicular means obviously he's standing on a particular floor. Okay, he's standing on a particular floor. Perpendicular to the principal axis, he's not sleeping on the floor. If they had told parallel to the principal axis, then I would have to draw that particular doll in a sleeping position. Whereas now it is in the standing position because they have clearly mentioned it is perpendicular to the principal axis. So fine. 2 centimeter tall, perpendicular to the principal axis of a convex lens. So I've drawn a convex lens right there. So after this, then what else? Yeah, the convex lens of focal length is given to me. The focal length of a convex lens can be either sides. That is this side or that side. We have already learnt it in the ray diagrams. So right now, focal length of this one, I will draw it to the right hand side over here. So focal length of a convex lens is usually positive. Okay, why? Because I am considering it on the right side. We know the conventions. To the right it is positive, to the left it is negative. And to the above it is positive, to the below it is negative. Recall this once again, that will be useful here. So the focal length I am drawing to the right hand side. So which means the focal length is equal to 10 cm and it is positive. Okay, positive plus 10 cm to the right side. So while I am reading the question itself, I will go on framing the answer one by one. So in this, the distance of the object from the lens is 15. Okay, this is the object. This is the object, and the distance from the lens is 15 centimeters. Is what they are telling. Distance. This object is to the left side of the lens, isn't it? If it is to the left side of the lens, according to the convention, my number, whatever they have given, that is object distance, is going to be negative. Why? Because it is to the left side of the lens. So clearly understand these sign conventions. If you have not understood the sign convention, please go through the video which I have sent already. Then come back to this. Otherwise, any little change in the sign convention, the whole answer will go wrong and you will not even get a single mark for this. Okay, none of the things matter if the sign conventions are wrong. So understand that first and then come to this particular topic. So here, after that, the distance of the object is 15 centimeter. Done. And find the nature, position, size of the image, and so its magnification. Fine. So all these things they are asking you. First is, okay, they have told that this object's height is 2 centimeters. So 2 centimeters is above. Obviously it is positive. Okay, whether it is to the right or left, it doesn't matter. As long as the height is above, so it is going to be positive. And the focal length is to the right side, that also is positive. And the object distance is to the left side, that is negative. The questions they are asking is about the nature of the image. Nature of the image means what type of an image it is. Is it real or inverted, or whether it is virtual or erect? We need to find it out. We'll come across that. Then they are asking what is the height of the object. Height of the image. So h dash is what they are asking you, and image distance is what they are asking. So, and also they are asking about magnification. Fine. We'll do it one by one. We already know this lens formula. It is a little different that of the mirror formula. That is 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. Whereas in mirror it is 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. So using this formula, I already know U and F, which I have already noted down. I need to find out what is V. It's simple mathematics calculation. I will shift 1 minus 1 by U to the right hand side. It becomes plus. It becomes 1 by F plus 1 by U. Now let me just substitute the values in this. F is minus 15. Yes, along with the sign convention, substitute the values. Do not leave out the sign conventions, okay? So this is where the sign convention plays a major role in your calculation. So understand this clearly, substitute it along with the sign convention. So H, that is F, is the focal length is minus 15. Sorry, it's a mistake here, I've done a mistake here. So focal length is how much? Plus 10. Okay, focal length is plus 10. The object distance is minus 15. Okay, so object distance is minus 15.
clearly focal length is 10 plus 10 here and your object distance is minus 15. I've written it. And let me take the LCM of 10 and 15. It is going to be 30. And here it will be 3 and here it will be minus 2. Okay, I hope you all know this LCM taking method. So it is 10, how much are 30? 10, 3 is 30, it remains in the numerator. 15, how much are 30? 2 is 30, 2 will multiply. And since because of this symbol will be present over here. So 3 minus 2 is 1 and 30 will remain here. 1 by V is equal to 1 by 30. Here is a chance of you making a mistake. One is, 1 by V, you will get it as 1 by 30. But what you will think is, V is equal to 1 by 30. There is a very common mistake made by students, that is 1 by V is actually 1 by 30. But ultimately you think that is V is equal to 1 by 30 and you write the answer as V is equal to 1 by 30. And that is a wrong answer. Whereas it is 1 by V all the way over here. 1 by V is equal to 1 by 30, which means V is equal to 30. And you can see you have never got, you didn't get a negative sign at all. So you have a clear idea that this V value is plus 30 centimeter. Okay, since there is no negative signs present there, that's why I can tell V is a plus 30 centimeter, which I can tell is the image is formed plus, image is formed at the plus side, which means to the right side of that lens at 30 centimeter from the optic center. 30 centimeter it seems, okay, somewhere here. So 30 centimeter, since it is plus, I can tell it is to this side. But I don't know whether the image is above or below. I don't know that yet. So let me find out how will I be able to do that. I found out what is my image distance. Let me write it here. That is plus 30 centimeter. I came to know that is it is to the right side of the lens. So fine. This is over. Let me come to something called as magnification formula. You know, already we have learnt about magnification and there are two formulas for magnification. H dash by H is equal to V by U. So that is image distance by image, image height by image, or the object height, and image distance by object distance. That is one and the same. So that is itself as magnification. So let me take that magnification as, I know two values things now. That is V also I know, U also I know. That is object distance I know, image distance I know. Let me substitute those values. V is plus 30, which I just found out. U is minus 15, which is already given in the question. I'll substitute it here. I will get the answer as minus 2. Since there is minus present, I will get the magnification as minus 2. Okay? So you have studied about a note in the previous video that minus of the magnification is minus or negative. The image is real and inverted. If it is positive, then it is virtual and erect. Yes? That is what I can clearly understand, that this nature of this image is magnified and it is real and inverted, and we can see this particular term is minus 2, isn't it? 2 is what I'm looking for. I can tell magnification if it is 1. If a magnification value I got it as 1, I can tell that the image formed is same height as that of the object, or same tall as much as that of the object. Now I got it as 2. That means the image formed is twice as big as the object. So here this will be the image formation, which is twice, this particular thing is twice as that of the object. Twice means obviously this image height, the object height is 2 centimeter, this will be 4 centimeter. That you have understood, but let me calculate and find out. So this is obtained from my magnification itself, that it is negative and okay, my niece is going bye-bye. Good night. Good night. Yeah, bye. Good night. Okay. Sorry for the disturbance. Then we'll continue with that. That is magnification. I got it as 2 and it is negative. Since I have already told, negative means it is virtual and erect. Virtual and erect means it is to the bottom side of it. Since it is negative, it is to the below of it, which means I can tell that 2, if I get it as the magnification, I get it as 2. I can tell that the image is twice as that of the object. If I get it as 1, it is same size that of the object. If I get it as 0.5, it is half of the object. Okay, so remember all these things, so it will be helpful for you. So now I already know that the magnification is minus 2. I'll take another formula. Since
I have not yet found out the image height. Okay, I have not yet found out the image height. Here I have told it is 4 because using the magnification. Though finding out using magnification, I'll do it in a better way. That is h dash by h, I'll take it, this formula I'll take it. And I will substitute the image height in this one. Sorry, here I will substitute. And the magnification value, I already know it as minus 2. And the object height, I already know it as plus 2 centimeters. So I will substitute this and this, and I will multiply 2 into 2, that will become 4. And I have already got it as a minus sign because of the magnification, which shows that the height is negative 4 centimeters, minus 4 centimeters. Minus means the height is to the lower side of the lens. According to convention, this will be minus 4 centimeters. And it is evident that if the object is 2 centimeters, this is going to be 4 centimeters, and the magnification is twice that of it. And the sign is negative because the image is real and inverted. So we can tell that the image distance, please write it in sentence, okay? So whatever questions they have asked in the textbook or the question, please write the answers in the form of sentence. I'm not telling in the case of examination. Exams, if you all have time, write it in the sentence. But if you don't have time, please make sure whatever the answers you're writing are put up in a box, okay? So make a habit, and whenever you're preparing a note, and since you'll have a lot of time, please mention all the things in detail in sentence once after you're done with the question or calculation. Once the calculation of a numerical is done, write every answer in terms of a sentence clearly. Okay, so fine. So first answer you'll be going to write is the image distance is plus 3 centimeter. The image height is minus 4 centimeter. And the nature of the image is real and inverted. And the magnification is minus 2. So these are all the answers for your question. So you can check in your textbook. The answers are clearly given. And also, every detail has been done here as well. So please go through all the video and prepare your own questions also. And as well as the exercise questions. Do not forget the exercise questions. And also, please solve the first example question, which is there in your textbook. 10.3, solve that question. Along with that, I want you all to go through all these things, revise the textbook once. That is all the simple things remaining, these questions to be answered, complete that, and this exercise is a must. So I want you all to answer all questions in this exercise. And any doubts you have regarding any question, please let me know. So I'll send you all the answers as soon as possible. So I want you all to finish this exercise as soon as possible. And meanwhile, I'll prepare a question paper for you all to write a test. Okay, so it can be either in the form of a test or in form of a worksheet. I'll give you all the old question paper questions. I will combine of this chapter and send you all the picture of that. So I want you all to be prepared for this full chapter. Any silly doubts, let it be clarified as soon as it. And first, my intention would be for you all to complete this notes and understand the basic concepts. Any doubts you all have, I will clear it. Maybe once when the classes start properly, I will clear that topics for you. Okay. So for now, please make sure you have understood whatever I have taught in today's class. Pause the video, understand it, note it down, put own sentences wherever needed. Just don't copy whatever I have given in the board. Make sure you put something of your own into these questions, these sentences or these notes. Okay? So give your best and finish this chapter. We can easily move on to the next chapter, which is much related to the same chapter. I'll move on to the human eye and the colorful world. In that chapter, much relation to this chapter. So I want to complete that chapter along with this. After this, maybe I can move on to chemistry and it will be easier for you all to understand the things. Fine. So please go through and complete the exercise questions as well as the other questions, whatever was pending in this. So finish this chapter and I'll give you all the worksheet for this. Okay. See you all. Bye.